Generalised anxiety disorder, or GAD, is essentially defined by excessive worrying. And this is tricky because we all worry, right? From time to time, we all worry about stuff. This disorder sort of epitomises the difficulty with the anxiety disorders in terms of drawing that line between what is within the broad parameters of normal anxiety and what is clinically significant anxiety. Some of the differences with generalised anxiety disorder and non-clinical worrying would be that people who have generalised anxiety disorder may tell you that they experience their worry as totally uncontrollable. They'll say things like, "I can't get to sleep at night because I can't turn my mind off." Now, if you're sitting there thinking, "Oh boy, I've felt like that in the past, maybe I've got this disorder," relax. We've probably all had times like that in our lives. For most of us though, those times don't last for 6 months or longer, which is the duration criterion for generalised anxiety disorder. When it comes to GAD, people might worry about all manner of things. They might worry about work or school performance, their own health or the health of others, the impression they make on other people, or things that are happening on the other side of the world, natural disasters, civil wars, and so on. In addition to the 6 month duration and finding it difficult to control the worry or anxiety, in order to meet criteria for this diagnosis, a person must also experience 3 out of 6 physiological symptoms associated with their anxiety or worry. Some of these physiological symptoms include muscle tension and restlessness. The distress or impairment criterion and the exclusion criteria must also be met, as with all the anxiety diagnoses. Often, with generalised anxiety disorder, there also tends to be a sense of hypervigilance, a sense that the world is a very dangerous place and that you need to be constantly on the lookout for danger in order to prevent bad things from happening to you. In terms of prevalence, generalised anxiety disorder has a 12-month prevalence rate of 0.9% in adolescents and 2.9% in adults, with females being twice as likely as males to be diagnosed with this disorder.